go for Patterns and the Boston Medical Center. But my former speakers have covered it. Right? You understand the urgency of the problem. So the magnitude is incredible. It is incredible, I say, because you cannot believe it. The numbers just don't do it justice. I don't even care. Is it 16,000? We have 40,000. The scale, we are undercounting by 10, 20, 34. In Boston, we saw our hospitals get overwhelmed. In India, we are seeing our crematoria get overwhelmed. Our graveyards get overwhelmed. We can't bury our dead. We can't burn our dead. So you can imagine how we feel about that.
Right.
You can imagine how we feel that brown deaths don't count. Why are they invisible? Why do they not register on a political scale, not even in the country that they are in, but in the world?
Right.
How is this okay? You know, we heard a lot of war metaphors, and it is a war in many ways. But, you know, I always favor a non-martial metaphor. And the metaphor that I like for us as humanity is we are a ship, and we are buffeted by a storm. And the difference between a war and a ship is that in a war, you don't defend the indefensible. But in a ship, every life counts. You don't just toss off the passengers who are not doing well. Let's not forget that. And, you know, put yourself in the shoes of somebody who goes on the street to buy oxygen for their father who's dying. The oxygen saturation is 50%. And they're told, yes, we need the oxygen cylinder, but it costs as much as 1 year of your salary. Would you buy that oxygen?
Unconscionable!
Unconscionable!
Shame!
Put yourself in those shoes, and you'll understand the problem. And you know what, Madonna? If you don't care, if you're saying, fine, we're a business, we're in the business of do-gooding, I get that. But you're making a bad business decision. Because from everything that we know, India is becoming a hotbed for variants developing. Infectious disease is the practice of applied evolution. We are trying to out-evolve this virus. That's what the vaccine is. But if we allow Indians to languish and the virus to thrive, the virus will get stronger. Already, just the last count I've seen, there are 771 variants of concern in India that can escape our immune systems and escape the vaccines that are given. So Moderna, your product will not be good if you allow India to languish the way it is right now. So it is enlightened self-interest that should promote you to not just say, hey, we won't enforce our IP, but to actually roll up your sleeves, get your hands dirty, and help out. And that's all I have to say.